Hi friends, today we will see how you can create an amortization table for your loans and also to find out the balance term once you have made any prepayment. So let's start with the basic details about the loan. So I have listed the basic details here. So I have entered the total loan amount. I have considered a sample loan amount of 30 lakhs. And then the interest rate per annum. So I have considered an interest rate of 9.5%. You can put the actual rate according to the loan that you have taken. And then the loan tenure. So you can put either in months or years. I have considered months here. I have considered a term of 5 years. So I have included the months as 16 months. And then you have the EMI. So for finding out the EMI, you have a lot of web pages or apps with which you can find the EMI. There is an actual formula for it, but you don't have to getting into that formula. It's quite complex. Instead, you can go just Google EMI and find out the EMI amount applicable. For example, I'll just type EMI calculator in Google. Okay. So whatever site that comes, that loads up, right? Go there, give your loan amount. See, the loan amount that I am considering is 30 lakhs and the interest rate that I am considering is 9.5% and the tenure that I am considering is 5 years. So I get the EMI. So you can just copy. Just a minute. Yeah. So you can copy this amount, go to your sheet, place it here. So this is the EMI for the details that you provided. Maybe I'll just modify this term to be more realistic. I'll put say 240 months, which is 20 years. Okay, I'll modify the EMI. So this is the EMI for a 20-year loan for 30 lakhs. Now let's start with the amortization table. So let me list the month as the first column. Okay. Month, and then I'm including a column for beginning principal. So this is the principal that is outstanding and at the beginning of the month, I mean even before your EMI deduction. Okay, then the actual EMI. And then actual EMI, then interest paid for the month. So this is actually the portion of your EMI which goes as the interest, which is credited against the interest for the month, and then the remaining amount, which is the principal paid for this for the particular month, principal repaid for the month. Okay, I can explain you with the numbers once I put the columns. And then the last column that I am including is the outstanding principal. Okay, after the payment of EMI for that month. Okay, so these are the columns I wanted to include. I'll show you how these values can be calculated. So let me start with this month, say, or probably next month. Okay, so I'm considering that I'm taking a loan. I'm going to start repaying the loan from June 2019. So let me enter the first month as June 2019. So the Excel, most of the cases it detects that particular value as a month based on the input that you're providing. So if it is not identifying it in the correct format, you need to right click and click on format cells. And probably give a correct format. Okay. Now it is automatically detected. So you can pull this, drag this column, right, this field, so that you can get the month values. So now your loan term, the loan term that you have considered is 20 years. So if you see, if the loan starts in June 2019, the loan would end around say May 2038. Okay, let me pull this month column till 2039 May. Okay, so I am just populating this value till May 2039. Okay, this is done. So you can adjust it later, you can cross verify, that shouldn't be a problem, but I'm just putting as a sample. I mean, I'm just entering 240 items in the month column, and then we have the beginning principal. So this should be, this will be equal to the loan amount. Now that this is the first month of the loan, so you can just click on equal to and point to this field. Okay, yeah, you have it here. And since this is going to be one constant field, right, you need to include a dollar here, dollar on row as well as column. Okay, both are constant. And then you have the EMA amount. This also you can include, you can point to this particular field, and don't forget to include the dollar symbol here. Else, right, when, if you don't include dollar, I'll show you what will happen. I think the amount will get increased, or it will take the next row probably. So for example, if I just drag from here, right, without putting dollar, you'll get zero only. But instead, if I add dollar amount here, for all the values, right, it will take the value from this field alone. You see the difference, right? Yeah. So I've included the EMA, and then for interest, right? So what I'm going to do is we need to calculate the monthly interest for this loan for this particular month. So how we can calculate this, you need to have the principal outstanding. So 30 lakh is the principal outstanding, and I'm just going to multiply this with annual interest, okay, divided by 100. Because the interest, right, you need to, if since this is a percentage, we need to divide by 100, and since this is an annual interest, you need to divide by 12 to find out the monthly interest. So both put together, I am just putting 1200 in the denominator, which is 100 into 12. 100 is for the percentage and 12 is to find out the monthly interest. Dividing by 12 is to find out the monthly interest. So both put together, I'm putting 1200. Okay. So when I press enter, I will be getting the interest paid for that particular amount. So one thing to note here is, right, the principal amount that will get changed every month. So every month we need to refer the beginning principal here. So no need to include any dollar symbol here. But this interest rate is going to be constant. So for all the values, that the interest rate that we are going to consider is going to be the same. 9.5 is the interest rate that is going to be applicable throughout the whole term, unless and until there is any change in interest rate. So ideal scenario, or the sample scenario that we are considering, we don't have any interest rate change. So we need to include dollar symbol here for both row as well as column. So now we have the interest rate, interest paid for the month. So out of the EMI, which is 27,964 that you pay, 23,750 rupees goes against the interest component. So the remaining component will only be considered as the principal repaid. So we can find out by deducting the interest from the EMI. So 4,214 is what gets adjusted against your principal component. Okay. Why do you have that this column here. I'm just deleting this. Now, to find out the outstanding principal, I'm going to deduct the beginning principal with the principal repaid. Okay, so at the end of first month, after paying 1 EMI, your principal gets reduced by 4,214 rupees. Okay, so now you can drag all these columns. Okay, bottom, and you will get the values for all. Let me check once. Okay, so here what you need to do is for the next month the beginning principal would be the outstanding principal from the previous month. You understand, right? So after the first EMI, this will be the beginning principal for the second month. So the EMI doesn't get changed. For interest, you can just drag this till 2 digits. So if we include this formula, right, the amount that I get will get rounded up to 2 decimal. So here also I'm just dragging this set here. Okay, now you see the principal, the difference, right? The principal is getting increased, even though it's very marginal. You see that the first month the principal repaid is 4,214, and the next month it is 4,247. Okay, and here also you can just drag this. Let me check. It's B9 minus, yeah, that's correct. Okay, so everything is perfect now. So now you can just drag all these fields together to complete your amortization. That's all. Okay, so what you need to do is from the second row, don't select from this first row, because first row the value that you have selected is different. You have selected a constant value, but here it's different. You have considered the previous principal. So you can just drag from the second row, I mean the row number 10, and drag till the last month. So effectively in the last month your principal outstanding should be zero. So here it is negative amount. This is due to the decimal differences. There are decimal points, right? Based on rounding up, there might be difference with the actual number. So one way that you can find out or cross check whether your amortization table is correct is, right, at the end of the loan term, say at the end of 20 years, as I mentioned, the principal will be either zero or a minimum negative number. So this is the way you can cross check. So now I have completed my amortization table for a given loan term. So here you can modify the basic information. For example, you can modify this to, if you've created a template, you can just modify this loan amount as 45 lakhs instead of 30 lakhs. So now that we have changed the loan amount, I've changed the EMI also. I've updated the EMI based on the web page. I mean, I checked the EMI from a web page, right? So I went there, changed my loan amount and got the updated EMI, and I entered the same amount here. So now the loan amount and EMI are updated, and you can see the amortization table for this updated loan amount. Okay, the term remains the same. So effectively at the end of 240 months, you can see that the principal is zero or a negative amount. Okay, now let's see how the prepayment will have an impact on your balance loan term. Okay, so let us consider, say after 5 years from the loan starting, you decide to make a prepayment of say 5 lakhs. So for that, let me go to the month, to that exact month. So the loan starts at June 2019, right? So then I'm going to June 2024. Okay, in June month 2024, the approximate amount that I see is 40 lakhs 16,000. So I just go there and update this as 35 lakhs instead of 40 lakhs. I'm doing this manually. I'm not modifying or updating any formula for this field alone I'm mentioning. So I am just making a prepayment. I just make a note here. Just for reference, okay, I'm just making a note, prepayment made 5 lakhs. Okay, so once I made this prepayment, right, you can see the change in the balance term. So when you scroll down, so even before your original term, right, the principal would have gone to the negative amount. So by October 2035, your loan will get over. So you have made you've considered a prepayment on June 2024 of 5 lakhs, which has resulted in your loan getting over by October 2035 itself. So you can also check how many months you have completed the loan. You can just drag these rows. So you can see 43 months earlier you can repay your loan 43 months earlier if you make a prepayment of rupees 5 lakhs after 5 years. So similarly, whenever you want to make a prepayment or whenever you want to check the effect of prepayment, you can just reduce the beginning principal by that amount and check when the principal outstanding becomes zero or a negative amount. I'm going to upload this template to the description of this video, so you can make use of this. You can enter your loan details and see the exact amortization details, and you can also key in the prepayments and check what is the new term that will be applicable for you once you have made the prepayment. So please check it, and if you have any feedback, please do share it in the comment. Please like and share this video, and please subscribe to our channel. Thank you.